The power of choices. The power of choices. It's very important to know what you choose and when to choose things for your life. Everything that accumulates to either you will get to heaven or you are going to the other part of heaven, or either you'll be very successful here or you'll be average, it all comes back to the choices you make. I think you can look at your life now and look at it. The choice of the university you go, the choice of the courses or course you read, the course of the job you have learned, even the choice of the acceptance of a job to work with. Moreover, you also know that when you are married, it's also a choice to choose one person out of all the numerous ladies in the world to be your queen. So you should know that choices are very important, and most times we don't really look deep into our choices. We just maybe give the choices to others to choose for us. I imagine at one of the questions one of our viewers asked me some time ago, he said, what did I see or how did I choose my wife? I was like, I didn't see anything. I didn't pray about it. I just chose. Because it's just choice. That wasn't the first time I was choosing right. I had been blessed with the innate instinct to choose. Choosing things correctly, from choosing the clothes to wear, to choosing the color of the clothes, to choosing my friends, to choosing my accessories, if I have a ring or something. I have been blessed with choices that are good. So when it gets to marriage, it's not like a new thing to me. It's not like I have to start praying heavily about it. I just knew that my natural instinct that chooses things would also choose a wife correctly, which I didn't go wrong with that. So, but look at your life today. Most of the things you are saying is wrong, most of the things that are not working is all as a result of the choices you have made. Now, do you know that by God's grace you have a way you can go about making great choices? Do you know you have a great thing in you as a human being that can help you out with making choices? That's what I want to point out to you today. You need to know as well that before you make choices, before your choices can come up plain, you need to know who you are making those choices for. Listen to me. Very importantly, you need to know who you are. Most of us don't know who we are. I always say something like, a lot of people live to whom it may concern. That's not how to live. You have to be conscious about everything. I remember saying sometimes ago that I don't like surprises. One of the reasons I don't like surprises is because I just want to know everything about who I am. I need to know where I am, I need to know what I do, and that's why I don't like surprises. So if you really want to make the best of choices for yourself, you really need to know who you are making those choices for. For example, who are you? Have you met yourself? Have you seen yourself? Do you know why you are doing what you are supposed to be doing? What is that your purpose? That's the first thing you do before you can make the right choices. If I have to wear a blue cloth, I should know that this blue cloth fits me. If I have to wear a big agbada or I'm wearing a suit, I need to know, does this fit my body shape? If you don't know what you are wearing that cloth on, you would have just chosen a wrong cloth altogether. That's why it's very important that the very first thing you need to do is understand and know the person you are making the choice for. Incidentally here, that person is you. So you have to look deep, know who you are. Secondly is, you need to know that there is something that controls the world. I don't know why most people pretend as if they don't know. You just say a lot of things to anything that has to do with spirituality. But the reality is here, no matter who you believe, whatever who you believe in, there is something you must believe in. You understand me? There is something you must believe in. But I can tell you from where I am now that you have to believe in Jesus. He is the closest you have to get back to heaven, to get back to your Creator. He is the closest person that can take you back to your Creator. That's why I'm telling you, if you want to make the right choices, you still have to be His friend. And He is asking you to do something very simple. You see, it's not difficult to accept Jesus Christ. You can accept Him now. All you just need to do is close your eyes, bow your head, and say, Jesus, I give my life to you. Direct my paths. And I want to be your friend. That's all. As soon as you do that, the next thing you do is, do not commit your regular sins. Leave those sins alone. As a matter of fact, your choices are being impaired because you have sins in your life. Sometimes you want to do something good for yourself, you want to take a good choice. Can you imagine somebody wanted to travel out of the country and he was considering the girlfriend? He's married. The girlfriend is also influencing that. Can you imagine? Somebody who needs to do good for his life and the family, and girlfriends now have influence over that. A lot of people are supposed to be big time men of God, but because of what they have done in the past, they can't even come out and say, I'm a Christian, because of what their past was. That's how bad moving away from Christ can make your choices wrong. That's how bad it can make your choices wrong. So the second point I'm giving you is accept Jesus Christ so that your choices will be polished. It's going to be an easy choice for you because you have somebody, you have a friend in you who can help you out with your choices. Moreover, somebody who is called Jesus Christ knows the end from the beginning. He's right there with you in the beginning, even before you were born. He's going to be there with you just now, and he will be there even long after you're gone. So it's easier to stay with him and let him help you out in making those life choices. And the third one I'm going to talk about is the fact that you need to pray. There is what we call the supernatural powers. Human beings cannot evaluate it. You can't use your normal brain to assess what goes on in that realm. It's a realm of the spirit. That particular thing helps you out when you are closed. There are some times, to be very factual, you have emotional issues you have to deal with. You can't use your brain. You can't use the tactical things you learned in school. You need help. In those cases when you need help, you really need to pray. And let me tell you, there is only one person that listens to prayers, which is Jesus Christ and God. And the two of them, both Jesus and God, had already told you, thou shalt not commit sin. If you commit your sins as you commit them, who's going to listen to your prayers? You see, it's very important that we stay close to our Creator. It's very important that you stay close to Jesus Christ. He is the only one that can listen to your prayers when you pray. He's the only one that can help you out when you are confused. Because a lot of times, especially for those of us that live in Nigeria, we are always confused. Every little thing, you have a walk, you've been walking tirelessly to make sure the company goes up, and one day you're hearing rumors that you want to be sacked because one new manager doesn't like you. Imagine you've been married for a whole 5, 6, 7 years, just suddenly your wife starts behaving funny, or your husband just starts hitting you here and there. You can't even explain it. Like, what went wrong? Where did anything go wrong? You can't explain it. At that point, you need to really pray. And when you are praying, it's only very possible for one person to help you out with it, which is Jesus Christ. Now, if you don't know who Jesus is, or you have not been close to him, who listens to that prayer? That's why it's important. So for your choices to be good, for you to make the right choices at every point, you need Jesus Christ to help you out. That's very important as well, so that you can pray and your heart can be in the prayer. The fourth one I'm going to talk about is what I call faith. We all know what faith is. Faith is the evidence of things you have not seen and you believe that it will happen. That's faith. Now, you actually need faith. As a matter of fact, if you don't have faith, there's no way your choices can be correct. Because every choices you have made or anyone you will make, you think they are wrong. Because you don't have faith in yourself and in the Creator. So I'm still winding it back down that when you have faith, the faith needs to really establish the fact that no matter what choice you have made, it's going to get you closer to your destiny. No matter what choices you have made, it's going to make things work for you. No matter the choices you have made, it's going to be the best choice out of the pool of choices that you have made. That's why it's important that you have your faith. Your faith is very important. Don't lose faith. Don't lose faith. Don't lose faith. The evidence of living actually is hope. Even if things are bad today, you are hoping to be better tomorrow. Even if things are good today, you are hoping it will not go away. We are not Jesus. We are not spirits. We are all human beings, because everything you have going on, with one step of mistake, everything could be off. And if everything is so bad, with one step of good choice, everything could be good. So you see how important it is to make a good choice, which incidentally will be very good if you have faith. Imagine David when he was at the camp of his brothers to give them food, and then he saw Goliath. It was a choice. Listen, God could have trained David all for years to be able to fight. But you see, David was fighting against lions and bears and all of that. He never thought about a real human being. So at that point, he had conviction that the God that he serves, that the God that is with, can deliver the Philistines to him. But listen, he has to make the choice. If David didn't make that choice to fight with the Philistine at that point, David may not have ever been great, because that was his chance. But he took it. Even when it looked impossible for him to win, he took the shot. You understand what I'm saying now? So your choices makes the difference. There's a place you have to take a U-turn. If you don't take that U-turn at that point, you may drive and never get to the destination. It's very important that your choices come at the correct time. It comes at the appropriate time. And the only person that can help you take those choices is Jesus Christ. Don't miss this opportunity. Don't miss this opportunity. You have to give your life to Jesus. He is the only one that can make things right for you. He can help you make your choices. And from there forth, your life will remain crispy. I can tell you that I have been there as well. God has changed my life around. He is helping me make choices every day, which now looks normal to me. It looks normal. I make choices, big ones, and it just happens. And I am always correct because somewhere is behind me doing that help for me. He is the owner of faith. He has improved my faith. He is the owner of choices. He has helped me make great choices. Great, 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 great choices. I hope I can share some of these, some of my great choices that I made sometimes to come. But I am beseeching you today that number one step is believe that your choices can be correct. Please, believe your choices can be correct and it will be correct. But if you are doing all of this all alone, then whatever you get out of it is your choice. You've been doing it all alone. But I'm telling you, Jesus can help you out. Do it for you. Help you do it. He's not going to take control of your life and not let you live. You are the one that will live. But he is like your mentor. He is like your diviner. He sees the front for you. He tells you what to do. And he just, you know, makes your life very peaceful. There's nothing bad about accepting Christ and living peacefully. And at the end of the day, you have all the money you want. You have all the peace of mind. You don't have bad debt because you are with him. Remember, the whole essence of Jesus coming to the world is to let us avoid sin and get back to Christ. So that's why your choices are important. I pray your choices will not lead you to hell. I pray your choices will not lead you to death. I pray your choices will lead you to something greater and greater, so that the generation here and the generations to come, when they mention your name, they will be happy that you are a Nigerian and you are from whatever part of the world you are from, that you are from that part.